Mr. Chairman, members of the committee, I'm honored to be here with you today to talk about this horrific issue that demands urgent, meaningful, and sustained effort. Sexual exploitation and abuse by UN peacekeepers is a cancer that demands the most comprehensive treatment possible, and our well-justified collective outrage is only useful if it's paired with action. I begin by noting that the United States has long been a vocal advocate for increased transparency and accountability as it relates to allegations of sexual exploitation and abuse by UN peacekeepers. We are pleased that this push for transparency is finally starting to find its first traction. And while it is clear, as you note, that the actions taken so far by the UN and member states have fallen far short of the mark, certain recent actions taken by the Secretary General reflect a new seriousness and create important new avenues for member state engagement. Some of these steps include improved reporting systems for victims and their communities, the creation of immediate response teams to collect and secure evidence for use in investigations, withholding of payments to troop and police contributing missions for their staff that have been sent home under allegations of misconduct, and the creation of task force in all peacekeeping operations on sexual exploitation and abuse. And I'll also note that in February, the Secretary General took the unprecedented step of sending home an entire contingent from the Democratic Republic of Congo who had been working in Central African Republic based on credible allegations of exploitation and abuse. This is the first time that the Secretary General has taken such a step. It sets an important precedent, and we believe it sends an important signal to troop and police contributing countries. We particularly welcome the Secretary General's action to identify the nationalities of those uniformed personnel who are accused to have committed sexual exploitation and abuse, including this information online in near real time. Troop and police contributing countries have the ultimate responsibility for the discipline of their personnel. And by providing this information publicly, the UN can motivate these countries to do much better. It also allows member states to track performance, to recognize serious patterns of abuse, and to use our diplomatic weight to urge the UN to repatriate units that have a systemic pattern of misconduct and to ban countries from peacekeeping where appropriate. This new level of information has also allowed us to direct our bilateral engagement where it's most needed. Last month, we launched an effort to reach out to every country on the UN's list in the Secretary General's report at senior levels to accomplish three goals. First, to make sure that they were aware of the report and the allegations concerning their troops. Second, to demand credible action in terms of investigation and holding those responsible to account, including through prosecution when appropriate, where crimes have been committed. And thirdly, to identify those areas where the United States might provide capacity-building assistance to help these countries better investigate and prosecute crimes involving sexual exploitation and abuse. I'd also note that the Secretary General's report included allegations of sexual exploitation and abuse against civilian personnel of the UN and different agencies. And based on that information, we are following up directly with those agencies to make sure that they take all necessary action. Mr. Chairman, any instance of sexual exploitation and abuse does very real damage to the credibility of the institution of peacekeeping, a tool that's never been more important for global peace and security, and one on which the United States relies to stabilize conflict situations that could otherwise spiral out of control. Last year, the President hosted the Leaders' Summit on Peacekeeping and issued a new presidential memorandum reaffirming our strong support for UN peace operations and directing new efforts to strengthen and modernize these operations. These efforts are well-timed to bolster our actions on sexual exploitation and abuse. For example, new commitments in the President's summit last year included 40,000 troops and police, and this should send a message to troop and police contributing countries that peace operations are no longer a seller's market. This increased capability should allow the UN to prioritize better performing troops in its deployments and also give it the flexibility to replace units potentially withdrawn for misconduct. Mr. Chairman, my colleagues with me today are well-placed to speak specifically to issues of the reforms we've pursued at the UN and the training that we provide and the capacity that we provide to peacekeeping troops in the field. I'll conclude by saying that by their very mandate, the vast majority of UN peacekeepers are serving under a mandate to protect civilians who are under threat of physical violence. Exploiting or abusing these same vulnerable people is appalling and an unconscionable breach of trust. And we greatly appreciate the attention this committee is bringing to the issue and share your outrage at what's been allowed to occur.
Thank you.
Thank you.